Anyway, it's time for the news. And right next to me, I have Lisa. She's finally feeling better.
Yes.
So,
Protocol Radio. We review
Newsflash. Oh, yeah, baby.
A little bit too late, but it's okay. Lisa, how are you feeling?
I'm good. And thank you for all the sweet words last week's book. I'm even turning my microphone all the way to my screen.
Yeah, it was so nice that we all like thought about you, gave you shout outs, and then I asked you if you heard it. No, I haven't heard it.
Well, I did hear it, and I actually did see all the DMs and also the people who commented in the chat, and I just want to thank everybody for the sweet words.
Okay, so the camera is yours. Get your 10 seconds.
No, this is it. This is just thank you guys. Love you. Mwah, big kiss from me.
Well, they all miss you, and we got a lot of DMs also if you were feeling better, so that means that you're a huge part of the show. That's really good news. So we wanted to start off because we have someone waiting behind the decks. Camarda, the finally one and only, is coming to do a show. But before we get there, we have some really nice topics to talk about. We're talking about the successful DJ that became almost became a firefighter.
Yeah,
you
want
to say something about it?
Who do you think it is?
I have no idea.
Oh, you can see it now behind you.
I can see it in
his
script.
Picture. Well, it is Fatboy Slim, and should I just tell you the story about it, but behind it?
If you don't know Fatboy Slim, obviously he is one of the legends. Also, the records of a long time ago. If you played FIFA, you probably know a lot of his songs because he had this song that was probably one of the biggest records out of FIFA, out of all FIFAs. Let me see. I think I maybe even have a little bit of a. Let me see. Oh, that's where I can get no satisfaction. But listen to this. So this guy.
I can't get no.
Yeah. Now, the funk soul brother, check it out now.
The funk soul brother.
So yeah, that's Fatboy Slim. So he almost became a firefighter.
Yeah. He mentioned that during a downtime in his musical career, he considered quitting music and become one. He even completed the medical prerequisites needed to be a firefighter, but he's now at the age of 57, so maybe he's getting a little bit too old for the job. That's actually his words, but he still describes himself as a wannabe firefighter. I think it's pretty cool.
Yeah, maybe, he's a hot guy. No, that's fair to say. First festival's opening up in our home country, the Netherlands again, Lisa.
Yeah, finally. And actually, Nick, I had a little bit FOMO, but I saw you went to a festival last weekend with some friends and not playing behind the decks, but like really being there as a guest. How was that?
You know, it was really funny because I got an invitation by a friend of mine. He's a dancer. He's actually a super talented dancer because he is the guy that did most of the dances for Chris Brown, and he was the only Dutch guy that danced with Michael Jackson on his last tour. This is it.
Yeah, Timur Steffens, right?
Timur Steffens, yeah. And he invited me, like, hey, let's go to this festival. We have a group of friends together with Rico Verhoeven, the kickboxer, and Joseph Klibanski, an artist. And we went there with a group of four, and it was a lot of fun to be on the other side than the stage.
Yeah.
We didn't want to go VIP. We just wanted to be in the crowd with everyone else. And the vibe, you know, of that festival, hearing, you know, this bass drums sound from like miles away, and even the smell of beer, you know what I mean, on the ground, even that I missed. So it was really, it was an amazing experience. And yeah, of course, we got asked for a photo once in a while, but it was fine, you know. I had a really, really fun day, so big shout out to the boys.
Amazing. And what did you need to show at the entry to come in to the festival?
So it's really funny because I'm very happy that we could finally go without having to wear a mouth cap, you know, or a mask.
Yeah.
So we just had to show a QR code that you were tested negative on COVID, and that was about it. So I did that the same morning, and we could go to the festival the same day. It was great.
Wow. Oh my God, so, that sounds so good.
You can even go to festivals in the Netherlands, guys. So hopefully we can see you on some amazing festivals here in Europe. It would be great. Tomorrowland joins the race circuit.
Yeah, so they teamed up with McLaren to put their Tomorrowland Around the World logo on the new McLaren 35M car. And this is actually the first time a music festival has been branded on a Formula One car. It's actually to raise awareness of Tomorrowland's second edition of its digital festival, and that will take place the 16th and 17th of July. And you have a McLaren too, right, Nick?
I have a McLaren, yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah. Do you want to ask something?
No, well, what do you think about it?
Oh, I thought you got, can I take it out for a spin?
Well, if I may, I would definitely want to do that.
No, I'm just messing with you. Yeah, I do. I'm just not so much of more of the Formula One. I'm more of the MotoGP. I like to watch the MotoGP a little bit. But, you know, I like to drive my own McLaren. You know, that's nice. That's something for a fact. I want to thank you, Lizanne. I want to thank WeRavio also for the news.
This news flash was brought to you by Protocol and WeRavio.
Boom.